Welcome to dear students. Today in this video we'll discuss about the classification of magnetism on the basis of the magnetic permeability. Magnetic permeability is defined as the property of the material to allow the magnetic lines of force to pass through it. Means the magnetic material can support the development of the magnetic field. Now in last video we'll discuss about in solid material the resultant magnetic moment of an atom is the sum of the orbital and spin magnetic moment of its electrons. The major contribution to the atomic moments comes from the spin of unpaired valence electrons. Number of such magnetic moments aligns in different direction to and it result it into a non-zero magnetic moment. Now when the material is placed in a magnetic field, the atomic dipoles respond to the extramagnetic field. According to that response, the materials are classified into three categories and also the basis of the effect of temperature and magnetic field on that magnetic properties. The materials can be classified as a dimagnetic materials, paramagnetic materials and ferromagnetic materials. These two, antiferromagnetic materials and ferrimagnetic materials, these are also types of the magnetic materials, but these are very close structure to the ferromagnetic materials, but their different magnetic effect will be shows. Means generally principle there are three types of the magnetic materials. First is dimagnetic, second is paramagnetic and third is a ferromagnetic materials. In this video we'll discuss one by one types of the magnetic material. Now we'll discuss about the first of the type of the material. First is the diamagnetic material. Diamagnetic materials are the materials when which is placed in the electromagnetic field. This material develops weak magnetism in the opposite direction of the electromagnetic field. Means diagram shows when magnet always force apply from south pole to north pole. The diamagnetic material shows in a magnetic field they will be apply the force or shows the force from north pole to south, means opposite direction to the magnetic field. Therefore these atoms, diamagnetic atoms, have very small magnetic moments and diamagnetic materials repel the magnetic lines of forces. The examples of the diamagnetic material is bismuth, silver, copper and hydrogen. The relative permeability means absolute permeability to the permeability of the free space, means mu upon mu, absolute permeability will be denoted by mu, and permeability of the free space denoted by mu naught, means relative permeability always mu upon mu naught. This relative permeability of this diamagnetic material is less than the 1. For example, permeability of the bismuth is 0.0083, copper is 0.005 and wood is 0.995. The absolute permeability means when the material is placed in a magnetic field, the magnetic field lines are redistributed and tend pass through the magnetic material. Means absolute permeability of the material is measure of degree of which the field lines penetrate to the material. And this relative permeability of the diamagnetic material is less than the 1. And diamagnetic susceptibility of the diamagnetic material is very small and negative. It is due to the repulsion experienced by the diamagnetic materials when which is placed in a magnetic field. Remember that diamagnetic material shows the relative permeability, diamagnetic susceptibility will be small and negative because it can experience a repulsion when which is placed in a magnetic field. Now second types is paramagnetic materials. These paramagnetic materials are the substance when which is placed in a magnetic field acquire a small magnetism in the direction of the magnetic field. This diagram shows the south to north direction will be magnetic field, means the shows the magnetic field of this paramagnetic material in the direction of the magnetic field, but will be very small, and therefore the atoms of this paramagnetic material slightly oriented along the direction of the external magnetic field, and this material shows the magnetism on the direction of the external magnetic field. Therefore they are attract the lines of the force. The examples of the paramagnetic materials is aluminium, tin, and the relative permeability of this material is slightly above than 1. It can be attract, therefore will be greater than the 1. For example, relative permeability of the aluminium is 1.00065, means smallly greater than the 1. Then another, the periodic susceptibility is less than 1 but positive, because it is due to the slightly attraction of the magnetic field when which is placed in a magnetic field. And third type of the material is ferromagnetic materials. These ferromagnetic materials are which is placed in an extramagnetic field becomes strongly magnetized in the direction of the magnetic field. These materials are strongly attracted by the magnetic fields, and these materials are strongly oriented along the direction of the extramagnetic field. Therefore, they attract the lines of the force strongly. The examples of the ferromagnetic materials is iron, steel, nickel, cobalt. The relative permittivity of this material are much greater than the 1 and dependent on the field strength, that is Mr is greater than 1. For example, purified iron and many magnetic alloys have relative permittivities of irons and many magnetic alloys is 1 lakh or more. The ferromagnetic susceptibility is greater than 1 and positive. It is due to the large attraction of the magnetic field when which is placed in a magnetic field. And above the Curie temperature, ferromagnetic materials behaves as a paramagnetic materials, and their susceptibility is given by the Curie-Weiss law, which is defined by chi is a magnetic susceptibility, C upon T minus TC, where T is the temperature of the material and TC is the temperature of the Curie temperature of the material. Now these are the overviews we will already discuss in this video. And this table shows the differentiate between diamagnetic material, paramagnetic material and ferromagnetic material. This table very useful for our university exam, because in university exam we'll ask question differentiate between the diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic material. And next, these are the definitions we already discussed in this video or previous video. I hope we have to better understand the magnetic types of the magnetic materials. Thank you for watching videos, and don't forget like the videos. Please subscribe my channel, Mr. Dhananjay Birar. Thank you.